Hi there, my name is Dylan McDowell. I'm going to show you how to customize user settings using Vanto Fleet Manager. In a previous video, we created a new fleet profile for Site A, along with a new user named Alice. Today, we're going to customize Alice's UI and instrument settings using Fleet Manager. Here in Fleet Manager, we have the Site A profile that I created previously, which we're going to go into by pressing the pencil icon down in the bottom tray here. Once here, we see the list of available users. I'm going to select Alice from the list and select the pencil icon once again. In these settings, you can see on the left-hand side the available methods to that user, and in the center, the live view for that particular method. The live view shows you exactly how the UI is going to appear to that user and is where you are going to be able to customize those settings. For example, if I didn't want Alice to have access to the spectrum setting, I could disable it by unchecking it. Now Alice won't be able to see the spectrum. In the bottom tray here, we have the favorites tray. This lets you set up to 3 specific icons from the menu tray for quick and easy access. We can customize that to be any icon from the menu tray. First, we're going to clear out some of these old icons, and we can do so by double-clicking them. Next, we can access the menu tray by clicking the gear icon up at the top of the live view. Here in the menu tray, we can select icons for our favorites tray by double-clicking them. For Alice, I'm going to add Browse Results, Grade Match, and Notes. And with that, I've customized Alice's favorites tray. Fleet Manager doesn't just let you customize the UI, you can also set specific settings for defaults so that when the user logs in, those are the default settings. To do so, you can select those particular settings from the menu tray. Simply bring the menu tray down and select the setting you want to edit, like test times, for example. You'll see on the right-hand side, you'll get those settings exactly as how they'll appear on the instrument, and you can edit them to be new defaults. For Alice, let's set a new Beam 1 test time to be 10 seconds. And with that, the change is made. In addition, you can enable and disable specific options as well from the menu tray. To disable an option, simply click and hold that option from the menu tray. This will lock that feature out from that user and they won't be able to make changes to it. Once you've finished making changes to that user's UI and instrument settings, you can exit out of the user settings by pressing the back button here in the bottom left-hand corner. If there are no other changes you want to make to the fleet profile, you can exit out of the fleet profile by clicking the exit icon up in the top right-hand corner. And with that, we finished making those changes and we're now ready to deploy our new profile onto our instrument. To do so, click the deploy icon here in the bottom tray. You'll get a prompt letting you know that you're going to be overwriting old settings on the instrument. Click OK, and it'll deploy it onto the instrument. Let's take a look at how it looks. Here logged in as Alice on the instrument, we can see we have the UI settings that we customized for her, along with the favorites icons that we set up down at the bottom tray. In addition, if we bring down the menu tray here, we can see that the test times icon is grayed out because we disabled it. And that's it. That's how easy it is to set up an instrument with custom settings and deploy it. Thank you.